Basketball, everybody's having locked out. NFL's was locked out for a little bit. Basketball's locked out for a little bit, you know. I like last basketball season, man. I like the NBA Finals. I had a good time watching it. I like the Mavericks versus the Heat, you know. I saw some subliminal racist shit when I was watching the TV games of that. Because every time Dirk Nowitzki got the ball, the announcers say, "Watch out, Dirk Nowitzki's a lot quicker than he looks." What the hell's quick look like, motherfucker? Dirk Nowitzki gets the NBA Finals MVP. He can't even get a shoe. When the hell's a white guy gonna get a shoe? We are long overdue for a shoe. At this point, white people, we need Nike or Adidas. We'll take Pony or Puma. Shit. Give me some Dirk Dada, some Steve Nash New Balance or something. I'll take some Keith Van Horn Kangaroos. I'll rock the Keys. I don't know why I ever got mad at LeBron last year, you know, because he went from the most beloved player to the most hated because he left Cleveland and went to Miami. I'm a comedian. I travel every week. I've been to Cleveland, been to Miami. Not a tough decision if you ask me where I want to live. That's not asking some dude, "Hey, man, who'd you rather fuck, Beyonce or Precious?" I'm going to go Beyonce. I'm going to go Beyonce on this one. Yeah, go Beyonce. But Precious raised you. You grew up with Precious. I don't want to fuck Precious no more. Saw this documentary on LeBron, too, called More Than a Game. They had his high school coach on there, and his mom was on there, and they said LeBron was raised by a single mother in Akron, Ohio, and then interviewed his high school coach, and his high school coach was like, "You know, if LeBron would have had a dad in his life, his game would be at a whole nother level." I said, "I don't think so. I think LeBron's better because he didn't have a dad in his life, because LeBron's got like a broken home type of game, because you could tell there's some pent-up aggression come from somewhere when he's on the court, because he'd be dribbling hard, passing hard, dunking hard. Where the fuck is my dad? Mom, shit! God damn!" You know? You ever see Kobe Bryant? Kobe had a mom and dad. Bounce pass, layup. "Hey, Dad." That's the one good thing about being a comedian, man. You get to meet a lot of athletes you probably normally wouldn't get to meet if it wasn't a comedian. Like I remember I met Dwayne Wade his rookie year. Me and Dwayne are friends. We ain't best friends, but we cool, we friends, you know. I call him, he don't answer, but he'll text me back sometimes, you know. But I don't know why, my son's 10, right? My son's 10. Last year, my son was 9, you know. I don't know why my son said, he asked me, he goes, "Dad, who's your best friend?" I said, "Dwayne Wade from Miami Heat." I know I said it, just popped out, thought he'd forget, right? Well, this past March, spring break comes around. I said, "What do you do spring break?" My son goes, "I want to go to Miami. I'm going to go to Heat game and meet your best friend, Dwayne Wade." I was like, "Oh, shit, are you serious?" So I called Dwayne, he ain't answer. He texts me back a few days later, said, "Come on down." And I tell people, man, you ever get a chance to go to an NBA game, go. If a player needs a ticket, definitely go. What I don't recommend, a mistake that I made, was Dwayne left me a parking pass. So I got to park in the player's parking lot. Don't recommend it to the average person because, you know, I fly down to Miami, I got my son with me, we pull to the arena. I'm feeling really good about my life at that point, you know? I'm in a Ford Explorer rental from Enterprise with the GPS and the XM in it. And Enterprise asked me, they was like, "Mr. Owens, would you like XM radio?" I said, "How much is it?" They said, $8 a day. I said, "Let's see, we here for 4 days, $32, get that shit. That's how your daddy does it, son. $32 ain't shit to me." I swear to God, we point at Miami Heat parking lot, there were some cars there I never heard of. My son looked at me, he was like, "Dad, you gotta get your life together." Like, "What are you talking about? I got XM, son, $32. Then Dwayne, I had a parking spot. I had a partner to Dwayne's car, right? So Dwayne left me a parking spot, and Dwayne drove a Maybach that day, right? And in the rims of the Maybach, he had DW. He had DW in the rims. My son was like, "Dang, Dad, what kind of car is that?" I was like, "A Dodge Wind." "Yeah, that's that new Dodge. That's that new shit." He said, "Well, it says Maybach on the back." I go, "Well, he got to take it back in May. That's not a good investment, son. We got to return that in 5 weeks, man. He must have bought that in June. He leased it."